Hi, and welcome to this video review of coronary artery disease. Let's begin. Coronary artery disease, or CAD, is a vascular disorder that narrows or occludes the arteries of the heart. Atherosclerosis, which is plaque accumulation within the arterial wall, is the most common cause of coronary artery disease. Narrowing or occlusion of the coronary arteries leads to an imbalance in coronary blood supply and demand of oxygen and nutrients, which can lead to myocardial ischemia or infarction. Patients experiencing myocardial ischemia or infarction may present with pain or tightness in their chest, jaw, abdomen, or left arm. These patients may also be clammy, diaphoretic, nauseous, and vomiting, may also complain of palpitations, shortness of breath, anxiety, fatigue, and more. It is important to keep in mind that women often present with atypical heart attack symptoms and may not complain of chest pain. Myocardial ischemia and infarction can lead to heart failure. As the muscle is deprived of oxygen and nutrients due to narrowed or occluded arteries, the muscle becomes less compliant and loses the ability to supply adequate blood flow to the rest of the body. Patients with heart failure often present with fatigue, hypertension or hypotension, dyspnea, edema, and pulmonary congestion. Patients diagnosed with coronary artery disease are typically prescribed multiple medications to prevent worsening blockage and heart damage. Medications for coronary artery disease include statins, which end in statin, S-T-A-T-I-N, like atorvastatin, antiplatelet medication or blood thinners like aspirin or Plavix, beta blockers, which end in lol, L-O-L, like metoprolol, calcium channel blockers, which often but not always end with dipine, D-I-P-I-N-E, like amlodipine, nitrates, like nitroglycerin, or isosorbide mononitrate, angiotensin, converting enzyme inhibitors, also called ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors typically end with pril, like enalapril. Angiotensin II receptor blockers, also called ARBs. ARBs typically end with sartan, like losartan. Let's consider some modifiable and non-modifiable risk factors for coronary artery disease. Non-modifiable risk factors for coronary artery disease include advanced age, family history, male gender or female gender after menopause. Modifiable risk factors for coronary artery disease include cigarette smoking, hypertension, dyslipidemia, diabetes mellitus, obesity, sedentary lifestyle, and a diet high in fat, sodium, and sugar. These modifiable risk factors should be discussed with patients, and as a nurse, you should always be on the lookout for these risk factors in your patients. These modifiable risk factors present a great opportunity to educate your patient on their risk and how they can make lifestyle changes to decrease coronary artery risk. Now let's try a couple of practice questions. Which patient would you be most concerned about having coronary artery disease? A, a 40-year-old premenopausal female with no family history of heart disease. B, a 55-year-old male with obesity, hypertension, and who currently smokes one pack per day. Or C, a 70-year-old male with a history of GERD who maintains a healthy diet. If you selected B, that is correct. A 55-year-old male with obesity, hypertension, and current tobacco use is at an increased risk for coronary artery disease. This patient needs education on his modifiable risk factors for coronary artery disease. Let's try another question. You see a patient with a history of coronary artery disease. You would expect to see all of the following medications on the patient's profile except A, isosorbide mononitrate, B, aspirin, C, citalopram, or D, labetalol. If you answered C, citalopram, that is correct. Patients diagnosed with coronary artery disease may be prescribed isosorbide mononitrate, aspirin, and labetalol. Treatment for coronary artery disease does not typically include citalopram. Thanks for watching this video on coronary artery disease. Please like and subscribe for more videos just like this one.